Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I talk about different ways that you can make money online as a work from home freelancer. In today's video, I want to talk to you about how you can use Bing Chat and the new Bing right now completely for free that is powered with GPT-4. And before now, you were only able to use GPT-4 with ChatGPT Plus, which costs $20 a month as of now. But as of last week, you can use Bing Chat and the new Bing completely for free, and it is also powered by GPT-4. I actually asked Bing yesterday if it uses ChatGPT 3 or 4, and it answered that while it doesn't use ChatGPT, it does use GPT-4 in the formulation of its answers. And the new Bing is the only way to use GPT-4 for free at this time. So I'm going to show you guys how you can use this, the different features it has, and we're also going to compare it to ChatGPT. So first of all, let's say you're on your Chrome browser or Firefox and you type in bing.com. To access Bing Chat, you would click here on Chat. And this is going to pop up that chat mode is only available when you have access to the new Bing. And luckily for us, that is now available to everybody. But to use this, you have to download Microsoft Edge. So you're going to go down here and click Open in Microsoft Edge. And if you already have Microsoft Edge installed, this will pop up. And you could just go ahead and open this up in the Microsoft Edge browser. And if you don't yet have Microsoft Edge downloaded, I've linked you to this page in the description below this video, and you can download Microsoft Edge for Windows, for Mac, for your iPhone, or your Android. So you can use it across all of these different devices. So I'm just going to click Open Microsoft Edge. Okay, so from here, you can click Start Chatting. And that is going to ask you to log in to your Microsoft account. And again, this is free. If you don't have an account, you can create one. And this is how we have to access the new Bing. There is also this feature right here called Discover. And here we have a compressed version of Bing Chat. We've got the chat here. You can ask questions. For example, what are the top hit songs of the week in the US? And what's amazing about Bing Chat is it is combining the power of search with AI. So whereas ChatGPT has knowledge up until 2021, Bing is actually telling us the top songs of the past week and giving us its sources as well that we could just click on and actually be directed to the source where they found us this information. You could also click on Compose. And this is where you can get Bing to write things for you just in the way that we would with ChatGPT. Now, I'm going to explore the Discover feature a little bit more later on, but I want to show you right now the new Bing and the expanded version. So we're going to sign into our account. Okay, so now that we are logged into our Microsoft account, I'm going to close the Bing Discover for now, and I'll show you this a little bit later. And all you have to do is click on Chat. So now we're going to have full access. So here it says, welcome to the new Bing. You can ask complex questions, get better answers, get creative inspiration. And one thing that's pretty cool about this is you can choose a conversation style. So you can choose more creative, which says clear your conversation and start an original and imaginative chat. Then you have more balanced, clear your conversation and start an informative and friendly chat. And then more precise, clear your conversation and start a concise and straightforward chat. So if you're looking for help on creating a poem or a story or something like that, you might choose creative. And if you're wanting direct factual information, you would choose precise. So I'm going to click on more balanced and I'm going to ask Bing, I need to write a blog article on summer smoothie recipes for weight loss. Can you provide me with 10 blog article title ideas? Okay, and so they've just come up with 10 different ideas. And they've also provided us some sources where we could check out these websites for some inspiration. And what's interesting about Bing is they even have some follow-up questions. Can you give me more details on the ingredients? What are some tips for making smoothies? You can see here it says 1 of 20. So what this means is that we can ask 20 different questions within this same chat. So over here at the side, this is our chat. So I'm going to click on this pencil icon and give it a name. So let's write blog article advice smoothies, for example, and then click the checked icon and then that's saved here. Now I'm going to say, write a 600 word blog article based on title 2. Okay, so now they've just given us this blog article. We could even say, can you write that again, but this time write the ingredients in a bullet point list form. And another thing that you can do is over at the side, you can click here on export, and you can export this as a PDF file, as a Word file, or a text file. So if I export this as a Word file and open it up in Word, you'll actually have a record of the conversation that you had with Bing. Now let's click on New Topic, and this time I'm going to choose Creative. We're going to write, I'm creating a fun video game channel for YouTube. I need to come up with a cool channel name. Give me 20 ideas, 20 original ideas. Enter. And you can see here that now this is our new chat on the side. Okay, so now I've just asked it if it can help me generate an original logo for a gaming channel called Game Puzzle Power. This is pretty cool. Wow. Look at this one. Created with AI. Oh my goodness. Download. And what's amazing about Bing is it is powered by DALL-E and it has created these logos for us. So this was created with the image creator that is powered by DALL-E that you can use within Microsoft Bing. And I would like to do a video to show you a bit more in detail how this works. I do have a video on DALL-E, which I will link you to in the description below, but you can see some of these are absolutely incredible. These are some ideas of images that you can generate using AI. Now, one thing I wanted to test is, you know, where did they come up with this idea? Is there a logo out there that looks just like this? So once you save it to your computer, one thing you can do to kind of check is I like to go into Google Images and you do a reverse image search. So basically you click search by image and then upload your image. So I'm going to upload the logo that they just created for us. And these are the ones that they're coming up with that are similar. So there's no exact match that I'm seeing. So this is an original logo. It doesn't look exactly like any of these logos that I'm seeing here. If I click find image source, I'm gonna actually just go like this and just get the logo. I'm going to click find image source and they're not finding anything. So this is an original logo essentially. It doesn't look like anything else that I'm seeing on Google. Let's see some other things that we can do here. We're still in creative conversation style. Mother's Day is coming up. Write me a poem that rhymes about a mother bear and her three cubs. Bing has come up with this little poem. There once was a mother bear named Blue who had three little cubs to take care of too. It's a silly little poem. And let's see if we can create an image to go along with this poem. Create an image of a blue mother bear with three small blue bear cubs. Digital art. Well, let's see what Bing comes up with. Oh my goodness. This is pretty amazing. Look how cute this is. So they have some follow-up prompts for us. Add some flowers in the background. Look at this. Look how cute this is. Honestly, just like that, we have an image, we have a poem, and now this cute little bear to go with it. This is crazy. So I want to show you some of the other things that we can do with this. I said to Bing that I'm planning a cultural weekend trip for a group of high school students to London, plan an educational 2-day itinerary. So they came up with this 2-day itinerary. And what I love about this AI is not only is it giving us the information straight away and planning an itinerary for us, but it's also providing us links to all of its ideas so we can learn more. And then I said, provide this in a table format. And it's created a 2-day itinerary for us. Then I said, I changed my mind. The trip is 10 days long, help. So now they've given us a 10-day itinerary. And then once again, I'm asking for it in a table format, and we must have 3 to 4 activities per day. And here they've given us this little itinerary. Now I want to show you how the new Bing can help you with your proofreading, your grammar, help you draft emails. So let's say, for example, you're applying to a job or you're reaching out to someone and you want help correcting your English. I'm going to write, please rewrite this paragraph in a professional way. And then I'm going to put quotation mark, paste the paragraph that needs corrections, and another quotation mark, and press enter. So you see I have this paragraph, it's missing punctuation and capitalization, and it is full of different errors. Wow, you can see the difference. You can see they did an amazing job of transforming this paragraph. They've fixed all of the spelling errors, they've added capital letters where they needed to. This is much, much more professional. So you can use Bing to help you with your proofreading, helping you check your grammar, your spelling, your punctuation, and helping you write cover letters as well for jobs. Now let's go back to Bing Discover. And the chat is basically just a condensed version of what I've just shown you here. But you can also click Compose, and Compose is kind of cool because you can tell it exactly what you want. So what you want to write about, you can choose the tone and the format. So for example, I want something in a paragraph format or an email or a blog post or just ideas. And then you can also choose the length. So let's say I'm doing a professional email that's short. Write an email to my boss telling them I can't come to work today because I'm not feeling well. And then click generate draft. So they've just given us this really nice little email. Dear boss, of course you would change this with your boss's name. I regret to inform you I will not be able to come to work today. I'm not feeling well. And then you would put your name at the end. And here you can just click copy if you want to copy it. You can also click regenerate draft if you want Bing to try again. Okay, and then you can click reload if you want to do something different. Now let's say we're going to do enthusiastic. We're going to write a blog post. It's going to be a long blog post. A blog article about the most active animals in the zoo. Generate draft. And you can see they're just drafting this long blog article that I can use as inspiration for my own article or change this up to make it a little bit more original. So this video is just to demonstrate some of the things you can do with new Bing. I really am blown away by the text-to-image capability and that you can do it all within new Bing. It's pretty amazing. Basically, if you're comparing Bing Chat and ChatGPT, I've just asked Bing Chat to compare them for us. Both are free if you're using the free version of ChatGPT. You have to create an account to use both of them, but Bing Chat is operating with GPT-4 right now, and the free version of ChatGPT is operating with GPT-3.5. And in order to use GPT-4, you have to get the plus version. There's also much more search capability with Bing Chat, and you're getting image results as well, and also the text-to-image capability, which I was showing you earlier. Now, one thing I like about ChatGPT is you don't have a cap. Like here, you can only go up until 20 within the same conversation. And I was having Bing Chat basically tell me it was not going to write me a script for a YouTube video, but it would write me a blog article. So there are some things that I think ChatGPT will do that Bing Chat maybe won't do, but I'm sure there are different ways to get around this as well, depending on your prompt. So I'm going to be exploring Bing AI more and comparing it with ChatGPT and seeing what we can do and how we can use this to help us in our own businesses and help us as freelancers. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments section below and let us know the types of things you have tried to do with Bing Chat and if you have found any limitations. Make sure to subscribe to Jennifer Marie for more videos like this one, and I'll see you guys in my next tutorial.